It seems like it wasn't so long ago that the world went into lockdown, millions of people lost their jobs, but for a lot of people who were working in offices, on computers, doing online meetings with other employees around the world through Skype, Zoom, or similar applications, that they were able to start working from home. And for a lot of them, it was a very comfy experience. At the time, I was actually working for a company that developed remote collaboration software similar to Skype and Zoom, and even before the pandemic happened, there were employees who were mostly working from home because of the long commute into the office. My direct manager was actually one of these employees, and since we used our own collaboration software to chat and do calls with one another internally, upper management mostly welcomed people being either fully remote or mostly remote employees as long as they stayed productive, since it was a great way to test the viability of the product we were developing. But a lot of companies are pushing back against the work from home policies now that the pandemic is over, and in fact, they've actually been pushing back against it for years now, and even threatening to fire people who don't return back to the office. But the latest company to hit the news cycle for pushing back against work from home is Dell, who told employees that continue to classify themselves as remote that they can no longer be promoted or hired into new roles within the company, essentially leading their careers onto a dead end. This is part of the new employee policy update that Dell rolled out in May, where employees would either classify themselves as remote or hybrid. Hybrid employees are required to physically be in the office for at least 39 days per quarter, which works out to about 3 days per work week. And Dell has even put a tracking system in place to verify that employees are actually spending 39 full work days in the office per quarter. And the main incentive, of course, for hybrid employees is that they're still able to get promotions and they can get hired into new roles within the company. Now, what's so ironic about this new employee policy is the fact that it is a direct contradiction to what Michael Dell, the chairman and CEO of Dell Technologies, posted on his LinkedIn page back in September 2022. At the time, he said, "From my experience, if you are counting on forced hours spent in a traditional office to create collaboration and provide a feeling of belonging within your organization, you're doing it wrong. Technology's ability to create a do-anything-from-anywhere world where work is an outcome rather than a place or time also enables you to create a strong corporate culture anywhere, all the time. There's a lot of benefit, not only to workers, but also to businesses, in the type of flexible work environment we began building at Dell Technologies more than a decade ago. Prior to 2020, 65% of our team members were already leveraging remote work opportunities 1 to 5 days a week, and even more tell us that they prefer it moving forward. It makes a lot of sense to let employees work from home. The main thing that I enjoyed about it was not having to commute and also being able to save money on lunch, because if you didn't pack a lunch and you had to get something around Copley Place, you would really end up paying out the ass for it. But the train ride, you know, my commute was 30 minutes for me each way. You know, that's about an hour of my time that I'm pretty much wasting whenever I had to go into the office, because it's not like I really enjoy riding the trains. And my commute was actually fairly short compared to a lot of other people. You know, like I said, my manager, he had to take the commuter rail to go into work. So it was a couple hours for him whenever he had to be at the office for an interview or whatever. And in most places here in the United States, at least, people are actually driving cars to work. They're not taking public transit, which creates a ton of traffic around 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. God only knows how much pollution is being created from the needless commuting alone. And you would think that these tech companies that lean so much into the going green gimmick would advertise remote work positions as part of their efforts to save the environment. But just like every other decision that these companies make, the back-to-office mandates are really profit-driven. That's what it's always about at the end of the day. You see, back in 2023, Dell laid off over 6,000 employees, reducing their workforce by about 5%. And with layoffs, employees usually get some severance pay and some extension of their healthcare benefits for a period of time and things like that. But when employees quit, they get nothing because the idea is you're going off to work for someone else. You know, now you're getting their money and their benefits. And, you know, ideally it's supposed to be something better. Employees quitting is even more beneficial just from a financial standpoint than firing an employee, since the employee might try to sue you for discrimination or all kinds of other things if you terminate them. So my guess is that Dell really just wants to downsize, and they want to do it as cheaply as possible without having to pay out thousands and thousands of severance packages eating away at their bottom line. But this might backfire. It already appears to be doing so with so many of Dell's employees wanting to remain remote full time. I don't think that Dell intended to downsize their workforce by about 50%. This is what I'm seeing by every news outlet that covers this, that almost half of their employees are choosing the or else option instead of becoming a hybrid employee. And from the perspective of the consumer, if Dell is willing to cut cost this way by just getting employees to quit instead of paying out severance packages to lay them off, what other way are they willing to cut cost? If you're shopping for a new computer and you're aware of the shenanigans that Dell is pulling as a company right now, you might think twice about spending $1,000 or more on a consumer-grade Dell laptop that you're going to use for work or for school for the next few years. Working at Best Buy, I saw firsthand the quality of Dell computers. Unfortunately, I didn't get to work on the Latitude laptops that often. That's Dell's business line of laptops. And just as a little tidbit of purchasing advice, if you are in the market for a new computer, usually the business class of laptops from any given company are some of their best laptops, and Dell is not an exception. As far as the work I have done on Latitudes, it's always been software issues. I can't ever remember having to fix something with a Latitude's hardware because, well, at least as far as Dell goes, they're pretty solidly built. But, you know, in Best Buy, we were mostly selling the Inspirons and the XPS, which we actually called the expensive piece of shit, because that's kind of how all of their consumer-grade computers are. And apparently what Dell did to Alienware is considered one of the greatest war crimes ever by older PC gamers. I never personally used a pre-Dell Alienware system, but we used to get a lot of their gaming laptops returned at Best Buy after the people who bought them realized that lugging that thick-ass plastic laptop to school and then whipping it out in class was the fastest way to speedrun back pain and not getting laid at the same time. But what do you guys think? Will Dell get what they want by freezing the careers of their remote employees? Or is it going to backfire massively on them? Tell me your thoughts in the comment section below. Like and share this video to hack the algorithm, and check out my online store, based.win, where you can get awesome merch like the Little Damon or Libre t-shirts and 10% discounts when paying in Monero XMR store-wide. Have a great rest of your day.